Hello and welcome to the GrandLine Review, your source for everything One Piece. Today we are going to continue our journey into the obscure facts presented within the ever-expanding Vivre card data book by covering the information presented within the Syrup Village and Baratier booster pack. Once again, thanks to the Library of O'Hara for the translation of this vital information, and as per usual, a link to Arta's website will be in the description below. But for now, let's get into it. And we are going to start out strong with the world's greatest swordsman, Drakeel Mihawk, who according to this was already very famous by the time the Great Age of Piracy began, which is pretty incredible to think about because he would have been only 19 years old at the time of Roger's execution. It still doesn't tell us exactly when he became the world's greatest swordsman, but we do get an abridged version of his journey with the data book stating that he trained relentlessly for many years, challenging more and more powerful foes until there was simply no one left to conquer, which sounds like a very similar journey to a certain Zoro, really. And so Mihawk became the warlord of the sea so that he could travel freely and is more or less living for the day when a swordsman will emerge that will surpass his old rival, Red-Haired Shanks. And before we all go mad with the idea that this indicates that Zoro will someday be stronger than Shanks, let's just keep in mind that the wording here is very vague and it may simply be referring to Shanks' ability as a swordsman rather than his greater skill set. Another very interesting piece of information revealed here is that Mihawk's original epithet was supposed to be Clairvoyant instead of Hawkeye, so that would make him Drakeel Clairvoyant Mihawk. It definitely doesn't have the same ring to it, although if it does hold true, then you'd almost certainly suspect that Mihawk is a user of Future Sight. And speaking of, the book does go on to confirm that he possesses both observation and armament haki, which I'm sure we already knew, but until stated otherwise, it does appear that he is not a user of Conqueror's haki. It's also confirmed that Mihawk does indeed have a bounty poster, although the exact number was not revealed, and it would be frozen anyway, so meh. Oh, and for anyone who cares, Mihawk's blood type is S, and he is 198 centimeters tall, which actually makes him one of the more average heights in the series, but still exceptionally tall in the real world. And finally, his favorite food is red wine, which is not a food, Mihawk. Next up, we have the almost as infamous Usopp pirates, consisting of Ninjin, Tamanegi, and Piman. And we learn that their favorite foods are carrot juice, meat stuffed with green peppers, and onion rings respectively, which is cool because it corresponds to their individual vegetable themes. And they go on to all have different blood types, with Ninjin being type X, Piman being XF, and Tamanegi being S, the same as Mihawk. And we also learn their birthdays for the first time, with Ninjin being the oldest of the three, having been born on February 2nd, whilst Piman and Tamanegi came along later in the year, being born one day apart on April 9th and 10th respectively, making all three of them 11 years old post-time skip. Then we move to the big cat himself, Captain Kuro, and there isn't a whole lot of new stuff regarding him, although they did rather interestingly make a mock-up of his bounty poster, as well as detail his exact height, which has him sitting at 207 centimeters tall. And fun fact, Kuro's old buddy Django also stands at exactly 207 centimeters tall, although his blood type is S, whereas Kuro's blood type is X. And moving on, Django's favorite food just happens to be spaghetti, but really the most interesting thing that comes out of this entry is that Kuro's favorite food is bananas, which is just insanity considering that bananas are the canon natural enemies of cats. Rounding out the Black Cat Pirates, we have the Meow Band brothers, Sham and Butchie, who both have the same blood type, being X. And interesting information here, these two actually have a bounty, which is not just one bounty, but a dual bounty, with the two of them being worth 7 million berries, which is one of the lowest non-jokey bounties in the series. But it's cool that they have some recognition, because it makes the Black Cat Pirates quite a decent force to deal with in retrospect, with the Meow Band brothers, Django and Kuro all being bounty holders. But let's get down to the most important information, which are their favorite foods. And first up, we have Sham, who greatly enjoys grilled fish, whilst Butchie prefers a different approach, going for classical fish and chips. Both of them much more cat-like than Kuro. Then we have the ever adorable Kaya, and I cannot believe that we did not already know this, but we discover for the first time that she is 19 years old post-time skip. So the same age as Usopp, as well as the same age as Mihawk when he was already globally famous. In any case, Kaya's favorite food is seafood, which is cheating in my opinion. It's like saying my favorite food is food. But her blood type is F, and she stands at 169 centimeters tall, making her the exact same height as me, actually. Moving on to the floating restaurant of Baratier, and has anybody ever wondered what the phenomenal Chef Zeff's favorite food is? I know I haven't, but it turns out it's spicy chicken wings. And furthermore, we finally find out how old Mr. Zeff is, currently sitting at the fairly high number of 67 years of age post-time skip, making him a mere 1 year younger than Emperor of the Sea, Charlotte Lin Lin. And as for the miscellaneous facts, Zeff stands at 189 centimeters tall, and no, that does not include his absurd hat, which pushes him closer to the 275 centimeter mark, and his blood type is XF. Although it should also be said that Zeff is one of the characters who had a wanted poster mock-up in the data book, although very intriguingly, his bounty still has yet to be revealed, which really makes me wonder what kind of number he could be hiding. I mean, if it was something like 30 million berries or anything under 100 million really, I don't see why it's being kept from us. So let's all keep an eye out for this senior citizen. Next up, let's look at the other two familiar faces of Baratier, Patty and Kane. And we've got nothing but hard data here, with the two of them being 29 and 34 years of age, with blood types of X and S respectively. Patty's favorite kind of substance comes in the form of pudding, and all of a sudden it makes a lot of sense as to why he was chosen to head up Baratier's dessert submarine of Sister Anker. Meanwhile, Kane prefers a classical roast beef, something I can very much get on board with, and stands at 171 centimeters tall, whilst Patty holds the honor of being the tallest Baratier chef, when you don't take hats into consideration anyway, as he consists of a solid 204 centimeters of pure height. And also, just in case you were ever keen on celebrating their birthdays, Patty was born on the 12th of March, while Kane came into this world on the 9th of February, which is my mother's birthday, actually, so maybe this will help me remember it for once. Now we arrive at the classically awesome character of Geen, who sports a blood type of S, and we have some news on his bounty, as apparently he is worth a very respectable East Blue number of 12 million berries. He also happens to be 186 centimeters tall, and rather touchingly, his favorite food is the pilaf dish that Sanji made for him. But by far the most intriguing part of Geen, oddly enough, comes with his age, which is 27. Now all of the ages in these data books are post-time skip by default, making Geen 25 during the Baratier arc. However, the fact that he has a post-time skip age at all is very promising, because it heavily implies that he is indeed alive. Then we have his comrade, the one and only Pearl, who does not appear to have a bounty despite being the one and only Pearl. What he does have is a truly excessive height of 239 centimeters, a lust for scallops, and a blood type of F. As for his captain, Don Krieg, he's ever so slightly taller than Pearl, with a mighty 240 centimeters of vertical ascendance, a blood type of XF, and the only other thing we learn about him is that he has a bit of a thing for eating grilled sea bream. Alright, now who's ready for some obscure characters? I know I am. And we'll start with Ripper, Rokaku, and Dukari, who you may remember as some of Morgan's subordinates on Shellstown, as well as the group of Marines who accepted Kobe. Well, now we know their birthdays, which is neat. And birthdays really will be the ultimate theme of every other character appearing in this miscellaneous section, so rather than spending too much time on them individually, here's a handy list of everyone covered. We have a trio of characters I'd completely forgotten about, being the tightrope walking Funan brothers, who were all part of Buggy's crew and all born on the same day, of course. More trio action from Buggy's crew comes in the form of the superhuman Domingos, all of whom were popped out on the same day as well. And not to be outdone, we also have the acrobatic Fuas, a four-person squad, all of whom once again seem to share the exact same birthday. How very, very convenient. The data book also gives brief mention to Ririka, mother of Rika, Pinky, the bird who captured Luffy and dropped him in Orange Town, as well as Hawker, who was the owner of both Shushu and the pet food store in Orange Town before dying of an unfortunate illness. And finally, we have Poro, who is best described as a random inhabitant of Orange Town who said something that one time, alongside Cox, one of the animals who lived on Gaimon's Island, and most obscurely of all, Domokun, who is one half of the alien duo who are planning to conquer the planet and make appearances every now and then in the story. Kind of like the Panda Man, but significantly rarer. And quite notably, Domokun's partner does not appear in this booster pack, because only Domokun made an appearance in Orange Town. But that pretty much does it for this edition of One Piece Vivia Card. If you enjoyed this video and the content this channel produced in general, then please do consider donating to the Grand Line Review Patreon, because the support of all of you amazing people is what continues to make this channel possible. Also, do check out my Teespring store if you're interested in shirts, hoodies, and other miscellaneous items, with the proceeds going directly to support the channel as well. And if you'd like to join the fun at any time, then please do head over to my Discord server, where a wide array of shenaniganry takes place on a daily basis. And finally, please do comment with your thoughts on this wonderfully obscure information. This has been the Grand Line Review, and I'll see you next time. You know that moment when you rock up to a gathering and you've worn the exact same outfit as someone else? We've all been there. And you know, I'm sure that next time Ripper and Rokaku will plan ahead. Maybe at the very least they won't have the exact same beard as well.